Hey universe, Earthlings love plants. Let's find out why. We have a lot to cover today, so let's jump right in and get started.
Hey everybody, Colton here from Universe Cafe, and it looks like we found a little clover here. Let's take a look.
Sweet clover is a nitrogen fixer with a strangely sweet odor. It has a bitter taste to discourage predation, prefers alkaline soils, and makes green manure or silage. This plant can be used in phytoremediation, which we'll see again later in the episode. Produced within is coumarin. This little guy has so many awesome properties, but is quickly reduced in the body by glucuronide transferase into dicoumarol, an equal in awesomeness. Properties include anti-HIV, what? Anti-tumor, anti-hypertension, the list goes on.
Well, it seems like yellow is a very popular color. Let's take a look.
This species of wildflower is not as ornate as some cultivars, but is native in America. The flower head is composed of many flowers and are arranged in a very peculiar pattern, one that caught the attention of a young man known as Fibonacci. Intimately related numbers produce an angle of 137.51 degrees. A man named Adolf Zeising later published what is now known as the Universal Principle, found in all things including plants and humans. The sunflower is great at phytoremediation. Oh, there's that word again. The ability to extract toxic chemicals from the soil such as lead, uranium, arsenic. All parts are useful, like seeds, oils, which act as carriers for biofuels, fibers and textiles, and also produced as latex, precursor to rubber.
Hey everybody, just out walking along right now and see this great little orange flower right here. And it looks like a monkey flower, so let's take a little looky at it.
The monkey flower was once thought to be in the taxon Mimulus and is currently in the lopseed family. A cold-tolerant plant, a sweet treat for hummingbirds, this serpentine-loving plant is a host for the checker spot butterfly. Both drought and deer-resistant, this plant will make a nice addition to my garden due to the fact that it produces geranyl acetate, an anti-radical, anti-inflammatory monoterpene. It has a pleasant fruity odor and is a natural constituent of more than 60 essential oils. This plant exudes copious amounts of this stuff, so we will definitely be back. Plants in the Violaceae family do exceptionally well in serpentine soils. Say what? A particularly extreme soil quality that has low calcium, magnesium, nitrogen, potassium, phosphorus. Flowers are hermaphrodites, that means containing organs of both male and female. This highly researched plant produces so many compounds that it has so many properties. Everybody should have one. Or two. Flavonoids, galactosides, carotenoids, cumaric acids, wait what? Homovanillic acids, salicylic acids, vitamin A, vitamin E, vitamin C. But let's look at anthocyanin, a water-soluble pigment that is dependent on pH for color determination. A sunscreen for plants to absorb harmful UV lights. How about cyclotides, a polypeptide of 40 different amino acids? This molecule is responsible for promoting mitochondrial health, preventing microbial growth, and stopping the process of retroviruses eliminating their ability to replicate. Oh man! Folklore medicine has evolved to a very real application. With over 500,000 plant species in the known universe, less than 10% have been studied. More than half prescription drugs available come from plants directly or metabolites or variations of compounds. I hope you enjoyed our presentation of Universe Cafe.